Hi guys, so let's now learn the popular Bollywood song Hawaii. And in this song, there are quite a few sections, unlike a Western song, right? In a Western song, you'll have a verse, chorus, maybe a bridge, and that's pretty much it. The verse will repeat, verse two will just have different words, and so on. However, in a lot of Indian film songs, whether it's Bollywood or music from the South or any Indian film music, what you'll find is the verse will not only have different words, but the tune will also change. And thus the entire chord sequence will change. The rhythm pattern may also change. So a lot to learn in the songwriting structure of a Bollywood song is the fact that nothing's going to repeat much except the chorus. So that's what's going to repeat throughout, and that's like your hook. That's what makes the song very catchy, and that's what you remember the song by probably after leaving the movie theater. So let's just break down all the sections. First of all, there's an intro which the guitarist plays. Actually, there's no piano in this song from what I could hear. Piano is used only in those really mellow songs in general. But you can play piano on quite a few of these songs. So in the intro, it goes something like this. So basically, this whole song's on the key of D major. Two sharps, right? F sharp and C sharp. So you go. So you do D and G chord in the left hand. G. D major. G major. D major again. And then that's pretty much it. That's the intro. Let me try and play it up to speed. Also add these notes to color it up more. That's F sharp for the first half and G for the second part, because it's part of the G major chord, isn't it? So, coming to the verse section of the song, most of the sections of the song are very chordal. So, if you're doing the verse, it's just going to be as written, on the chart on your right-hand side of the video. It'll basically be D, G, A, D, and an occasional E minor. And what's very important to point out here is when you see the D and the E minor chords, they are both played together within four counts. So if you're doing the verse, it'll be 1, D major, then 4, G major, then 5, A major, and back to 1, 2, na, na, and then you go D major again. Let's just go through the verse, and I have Naveen here, who's our in-house amazing singer. So let's try and do the verse together, Naveen, whenever you're ready. It's D. Your whole verse section, and there are three verses in the song, right? So verse one, you play this chord structure, Verse 3 also you play this chord structure. However, in verse 2, it's slightly different. So we'll do verse 2 shortly. Let's now move to the chorus, okay, which is a very, very catchy part of the song. And what's even catchier is it goes to a kind of a chanting section, which it's a song where you can remember two things, actually, as we're going to show you. The chorus as well as that chanting part after, which is oh, and so on. So, and they put both these parts together. So they'll do the chorus, which has lyrics, and then it goes to that chanting O part, which obviously doesn't have lyrics. Okay, so let's first do the chorus with Naveen, and then I'll break down the chords after we do it once. Le jaye jaane ka So let's break that down. So it starts with, it's basically G D G D G D G D. Like that's literally, as you can see here, G D G D G D G D. So you just play that in a succession, and when you end the chorus, you're playing E minor, A major, and then ending on D major. So I'll just try to hum it very poorly. So try to ignore my singing. So na 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 vai. Four times na 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 D major, na 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 G major, da 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 D major again. So whenever you end the chorus, you play E minor, A major, D. Let's do it one more time, Navi. That's your G. Four times, and now D. Four times. E, A major, D. Okay, and then when it goes to that O part, G major. So it's quite a 1-4-5 rooted song, isn't it? By 1-4-5, what I mean, the one of the scale, which is G major. Then the four of the scale, which is C major, right? And the five of the scale, which is D major, right? So a lot of the catchier songs you hear, whether it's, any language pretty much will always generally have this 1-4-5. Even if you take Knocking on Heaven's Door by Guns N' Roses, it has pretty much the same chords, or La Bamba, or any such song, right? So let's now move into the verse 2 section. And the verse 2 section is quite interesting because the chords are different, the melody is also slightly different, right? So let me first play it with the singing, and then we'll try and break it down together. To the chorus, right? So let's break down verse 2. There's an interesting chord which I pointed out here, which is a major seventh chord. So major seventh chord will have a normal major, but in addition to that you add the major seventh interval. So from the D major chord, the major seventh is C sharp, right? It's the seventh note in the D major scale. So just to make that D major sound a little bit more interesting, they add a major seventh as well. No, no, no. Okay, so at that point you do na 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 D major. That's a D major seventh going to G. Na 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 na. That's an E minor. Right, and that repeats into two. Okay, and then it goes into the chorus. So let me just do it once more and call out the chords with the singing. One, two, go. D major. Major seventh. G. E minor. A major. D. D. Major seventh. G, E minor, A major, D, and so on. And a lot of the times in the song, this it'll just break at the last chord, na 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 na, and so on. And then that builds up that anticipation to the chorus, right? And also D major seventh, I'm not playing like this. That makes the seventh stick out too much. So na 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 na. So try to play it in this style, D major, D major 7th. I'm just moving the root to the 7th, which is right here. Okay, so that pretty much covers this entire song. The one thing I'd like you to consider adding to make the song a little bit more colorful, as it actually is in the original. Now, in the original song, there's a lot of other elements. There's orchestration, there's synths, there's guitars, there's bass, there's a lot of harmonic elements. For you to make it a little bit more colorful on the piano, what I would advise you to try and do, if you can, is to add some chord extensions. So, if you're doing the chorus, it's just a simple G going to D. So, what you could do to make it more interesting is every time you see a major chord, try and add a major seventh, like I taught you for the D. So it adds a very interesting flavor. Right, so that's your D major seventh. That adds to the vibe of the song and probably makes it a little bit more romantic, right, Naveen? Possibly. Yeah, so the major seventh chord adds that sort of vibe. And also when you take the minor chord, what is that? You have E minor, right? Even the E minor, you can add the minor seventh. So if you want to form a minor seventh, you take any minor chord you know and touch the minor 7th, which is nothing but a flat 7. Okay, so if you want to color up the chorus, so that's the major 7, we want to color it up more, you can add this A. And a trick which I usually do is, instead of playing one note with your thumb is always this really cool finger which can just stretch out, and you can play two notes, right? So instead of the major 7th, you can add this 9th to add to the vibe of the song. The same thing you can do for D, make it a D major 7th, or you can add the 9th. So the 9th is nothing but the 2nd from the root of the chord. So if you take D, its 2nd is E. Thank you. you can play normal chords there, or if you want, you can add a minor seventh. A, and then, okay, let me try and do the chorus just to conclude with Naveen singing and try to add some extensions and some color. Okay, yeah. Le jaye tujhe ko Hawaii, Hawaii. So quite a cool song, and have fun playing it, have fun jamming it with your friends. If you can sing better than me, I'm sure you'll have a blast singing and playing it with the piano or the guitar. I definitely can't, so that's why I rely on people like Naveen to sing with me. Right, cheers, and see you in the next video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that bell icon for notifications. Leave us a comment for any other video you'd like us to do next. And don't forget to share the video with all your musician friends. Cheers.